this is April 5, Wednesday, and we are in BBIS class, and we'll begin by listening to someone tell us what we did in the last class, and then we'll begin the class. So let me call someone here. Anyone can come with a note coffee and just read out what we did in this class. Just come with your coffee and read out. Anyone? Hello? Anybody can come with a note copy and read out what we did in the previous class. Hello? Roll number 7. Who is 7? Nobody 7?
Oh God.
17. Nobody 17? Here we have. Avinav Karga. Absent? Okay. Meravi. Oh, just came. Let me mark your pages. Can I get the pen? I have one here.
I want here.
So, Meravi is present. Okay, let me call Sneha Bhardar. Come with the notes. Come with the notes. Okay, we talked about dialectic materialism. What else?
History of
What else?
Conflict between two opposite sources.
Okay, conflict between two opposite forces. What else?
Conflict between free man and slave.
Okay, examples were there. Free man and then slave, etc. What else?
Social order, hierarchy.
Then we talked about society as rank, order, gradation, upper and lower. What else? That's all. So which para were we dealing with? Someone? Which para?
Seven.
Seven? Seven? Really? Okay, thank you. Thank you. Sneha, your face got caught on the camera, is it okay? Because I need a permission. I need a permission, right? Because you were walking down and the camera accidentally caught your face. Okay. Can I use someone's book if you have one? Can I use someone's book? Or let me also show you the text also, okay? Can you turn on the projector? Come in. Come in, come in, come in. Come in. Okay. Paragraph 7. Could you read the first sentence in the paragraph? What was the paragraph 7? Four, five, six, seven. The feudal system?
Yes,
okay. So in paragraph 1 he says there is class struggle. In paragraph 2 he gives example of classes struggle. In paragraph 3 he says that there are social ranks, orders, hierarchies, up and down. And the people at upper level exploit people at lower level. Paragraph 4, he says that modern bourgeois class developed from the ruins of the feudal class. Paragraph 5, he says that the modern bourgeois class has created more classes. There are more sections in society and they are fighting with each other. In paragraph 6, Marx explains how from the serfs of the Middle Ages sprang the chartered burghers, and from these burgesses the earliest towns developed, right? This was the point we were reading. Marker? We don't have one, right? Yeah? Well, let me come with a marker. Clearly understand the formation and growth of this bourgeois class. There were serfs, right? These serfs were people who did not own land, but they tilled land. And this land belonged to the feudal lord. And they provided their labor to the lord, and the lord provided protection by giving money and other things. So these serfs, later on they were given land and they got land, so they began living in one place. Now when they began living in one place, this developed as a burgher. People will live together. Now from this burgher is one who lives in burgess. Burgess is village. And from this burgher there developed burgesses. And when there were too many burgesses formed together, too many burgesses formed together, this developed into the form of earliest town, right? And as it was town, you will see. Why are you doing this? A ghila also when you order this, my guy was supposed to be sorry, also when you say it. Roll number.
11.
11. 11. And they are so Ujjwal. 11.
14.
14. Oh God. 14.
9.
5.
9.
9. RC. Or
21.
Oh God. 30 jan. Abriti. Or 5. 5 Raunak.
Friends,
5 Raunak. Aru.
Mona Lisa.
Okay. And because these were towns, and you know when there is town or market, towns have more business activity, less agricultural activity. So in these towns, there was more business activity, and where there is business activity, there is more money making. And when there is more business activity, then we have business class. So there was the rise of business class, right? which is also known as middle class. We also call it middle class or the bourgeois class. It is the same thing. Call it bourgeois class, middle class, business class. So they developed from these towns. So these serfs developed into middle class. This was what we read last time. Let's read ahead. So, okay. Yes. Now, Marx is explaining the rise of capitalism or the rise of middle class from para 6 onwards. I'll go to para 7 and read para 7. So in para 7 we read, the discovery of America, the rounding of the Cape opened a fresh ground for rising bourgeoisie. And be careful, there are two words, B-O-U-R-G-E-O-I-S, we pronounce as bourgeois. The other word is B-O-U-R-G-E-O-I-S-I-E, we pronounce as bourgeoisie. The bourgeois is adjective, the bourgeoisie is noun. Okay. Similarly, we have the proletarian adjective, the proletariat as noun. Okay, so Marx explains further factors that led to the development of the middle class. For example, one, discovery of America, right? Second, it talks about Cape, maybe it is the international route, I guess. Then third, it talks about the East India Company that came to India for business. Then fourth factor, it says the Chinese market, the rise of Chinese market, right? Then fifth, it says colonialism of America. America ruled over the world in many countries and did business. Then sixth, he says trade with the colonies. Right? Then now all these factors led to the increase in exchange, they led to the increase in the means of exchange, okay. Increase in the means of exchange and in commodity. Commodity, and then there was more commerce around the world, more business, right? Then to navigation, look. There was more navigation, more ships went around the world taking goods to different countries. And then there were more industries being opened around the world to supply growing demand. Then before known, and thereby to the revolutionary element in the tottering feudal society, a rapid development. Now all this new change gradually destroyed the feudal class and gave rise to the business class. That's how the modern bourgeois class developed. So in paragraph 7, Karl Marx, in 6, he starts telling the rise of bourgeois. In 7, he explains further how bourgeois developed. And he gives these reasons. America, you know, America supports capitalism. America supports free economy, right? Whereas Russia supported communism. So America promoted capitalism on the world. And America, as a powerful country, it ruled over other countries like Africa and others. And America did business to other countries, which it ruled over. So there was promotion of business, right? More goods were produced. These goods were taken to other countries for selling them and getting money. And so as a result, there was more economic activity around the world. Ships will go across continents to countries, right? They will come back. They will take goods. They will bring money. There was more economic activity. And because there was more supply, more demand, growing population, gradually money making went on. A new class emerged, the business class. People who owned factories, industries, and they produced and they sold around the world, business class. And with this, we have the modern bourgeois class. So para 6 and 7, they explain the rise and development of the modern bourgeois class against the ruins of the feudal class. One thing, keep in mind, do you see, the technique that Karl Marx is using is, in paragraph 234, he compares. In paragraph 234, he compares. Pay attention to rhetoric also. How he's saying, he's comparing two classes, section classes, he compares, right? And then he surveys. He's surveying throughout the history, he's surveying. He is summarizing the history. So the technique is comparison, contrast, and survey. Because you need to understand the technique also. That is called rhetorical strategy. What is the rhetorical strategy in these paragraphs? There are two strategies. One, comparison contrast of the classes, and a quick survey of the history. Okay. Let's read the next paragraph and see what is there. So we read the next paragraph. You follow as I read, I'll explain here. The feudal system of industry, in which industrial production was monopolized by closed guilds, now no longer sufficed for the growing wants of the new market. The manufacturing system took its place. The guild masters were pushed on one side by the manufacturing middle class. Division of labor between the different corporate guilds vanished in the face of division of labor in each single workshop. Let me explain this thing. First, you had feudal, social, political system in the past. Now, in a feudal, social, political system, there were feudal industries, let's say places where goods were produced. Now, these feudal industries were controlled by the guild masters. Okay. Who is a guild master? A guild is association of similar business. For example, Plumbers Association is a guild. A guild master is the leader of that association. Electricians Association is a guild. Now the leader is the guild master. So a guild is group of similar businesses. A guild is group of similar businesses, and guild master is one who is controlling that business, right? So what you need to understand is that production, just as land was controlled by the lord, the feudal, production also was controlled by the guild master. And this feudal industry did not have much tool, it did not have much technology, it was not scientific. Manual labor was used, right? There was no technology, so production was slow. And production was not a huge amount, right? But it was supplying needs of the society at the time. There was less population, less demand, so it was okay. But what happened? You will see, gradually population began to increase. Population began to increase. How did the population increase? How did the population increase? You remember earlier in paragraph 3, 4, 5, what he said? There were serfs. They began to live in burgesses. They began to live in burgesses. And the burgesses never went to towns. So you will see, population was increasing. It was increasing. And when population increases, it leads to growing demand. Right? If there is rise of population, there is rise of demand. Right? And when there is rise of demand, there is pressure on supply. Right? So, these industries came under a pressure to supply larger demand because population was growing. But the problem was that they could not produce in huge amount. So, there was a deficit. There was more demand and less supply. More demand and less supply. See the economic condition. Higher demand, lower supply. Now what happened? Read the line, what happened? As a result, manufacturing system took its place. Now, feudal industries were replaced by manufacturing system. And what you need to understand is that when the production system changes, social class also changes. So feudal industrial system was controlled by middle masters. Now manufacturing system was controlled by the manufacturing system was not controlled by guild masters. There came more businessmen. There was decentralization now, in a sense. Earlier, few people controlled production. Now, more people entered in the process of production. More businessmen came. बुझ्छ नि यही पनि त पहिले एउटा व्यापारले काम गरेर आउँछ अनि पछि त नाफा देखेर चाहिँ मान्छे काम गरेर आउँछ नि थुप्रै मान्छे आउँछ नि आउँदैन व्यापारमा अनि कम्पिटिसन सुरु हुँदैन अर्लियर एभ्रिथिङ वाज कन्ट्रोल्ड बाई गिल्ड मास्टर्स वान पर्सन एन्ड द्याट वाज नट इनफ टु सप्लाई द डिमान्ड नाउ फ्युडल इन्डस्ट्रियल सिस्टम वाज रिप्लेस बाई म्यानुफ्याक्चरिङ सिस्टम विच वाज कन्ट्रोल्ड बाई मिडल क्लास अब अनदर डिफरेन्स In the manufacturing system, they introduced labor division. Labor division was here also, but it was not very, very good. There was more labor division. They introduced tools, they introduced technology. As a result, their production increased. And they could meet the supply. They could meet the demand now. There was more supply that could meet the new. So what do you see? One thing keep in mind, economic activity is rising and more people are coming into business. A new class is rising, the class of money-making people. The class of money-making people that is called the bourgeois class, middle class, business class. Okay. Can I hear this? Read next. So we said that the feudal system was replaced by manufacturing system. Guild masters were replaced by manufacturing middle class. Division of labor between the different corporate guilds disappeared and there was labor in each single workshop. First, one person made one item, another person made another item. Now within one factory there was division of labor, right? This person will do one thing, look. Now he will, if it is a port factory, so he will sew only the button, He will see only the collar, he will see only the arms, like that. There was more division of labor. And when this happens, production becomes fast. Production becomes fast. Because single person is working the same thing throughout the day, so they will work fast. Read next paragraph. Meantime, the markets kept ever growing. Now look, we began with the serfs, then we came to burgesses, then we came to towns. Now in this development, one thing is constantly increasing. What? What is increasing? And when market increases, middle class rises, right? Let's see. Meantime, the markets kept ever growing, the demand ever
rising.
Look, markets are going up. Why? Because there is manufacturing system, because there is labor division, more production. As markets are growing, demand is also. So, demand is increasing. And supply is also increasing. When demand and supply increase, there is more economic activity. There is more economic activity. When there is more economic activity, what class rises? What class rises? Middle class. Read ahead. Meantime, the market kept ever increasing, the demand ever rising, even manufacturer no longer sufficed. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that, first, there was feudal industry, right? It failed to meet the demand. Then came manufacturing system. It also failed to meet the demand. Why? The demand was constantly increasing. Why was demand increasing? Why was demand constantly increasing? Population was increasing. यतिनी बुझ्दैन इन्भेस्ट पर्ट मान्छेले बिजनेस पर्छ यतिनी बुझ्दैन डिमान्ड किन बढ्छ पपुलेसन बढ्नु पर्छ यति सिम्पल कुरा पनि जवाफ दिँदैन बजारमा डिमान्ड किन बढ्छ अनि यति पनि बोल्दैन चुपडाएर बस्छ सोध्दै नाउ म्यानुफ्याक्चरिङ सिस्टम अल्सो फेल्ड अहिले के भइरहेछ लुक एज डिमान्ड इज राइजिङ बिकज अफ पपुलेसन द प्रोडक्सन सिस्टम इज चेन्जिङ Production system is changing. And each next stage in the system is able to produce more and more. To produce more and
more.
Read ahead, follow them. The place of manufacture was taken by giant modern industry. That's for the solution. Yes, it is. Bottom malekum. Feudal industry. Right? You feel why? Manufacturing system. Epeni felva. Abhagya vana. The place of manufacturing taken by giant modern industry. Giant modern industry. Move ahead. The place of industrial middle class by industrial millionaire. Look here. This is economic aspect, right? Say. Abhi yeah, social aspect. Social aspect, say. Feudal industry. Feudal class. Feudal industry. Feudal class. Controlled by guild master. Manufacturing system. Middle class, giant modern industry, middle class. The place of manufacture was taken by giant modern industry, the place of industrial middle class by industrial millionaire. The leaders of the whole his army is the modern bourgeois. Now, this was leader of industries or the modern bourgeois. So look, middle class was replaced by modern bourgeois. So do you see, what you need to understand is that as the economic factors change, the social class also changes. As economic relations change, social relations also change. A new, with the change in production system, a new class is born. With each change in production system, a new class is born. You had feudal production system, you had feudal class. You had manufacturing system, you had middle class. You had giant modern industrial system, you have bourgeois. Today you have Elon Musk, he is a bourgeois. Example of bourgeois, who controls all the money. Warren Buffett, example of bourgeois. Ambani, example of bourgeois. Bill Gates, example of bourgeois. Because they run all the industry, they have all the money. Okay, move ahead. Look, Karl Marx, his writing is very clear, but you need to have patience and read. And you can't understand without reading. Karl Marx's writing is very lucid and clear. Easily understand. Okay, read that. Modern industry has established the world market. Look, now, we have modern industry and it has world market. Look, this marker I'm using. Let's check where is it made. We are in Nepal. And it says, this is made in India. It's made in India. Look, we are Nepalese people. And in our schools, we are not using Nepali product. We are using Indian product. For example, the world market. Read ahead. For which the discovery of America paved the way. What happened? Okay, it's all right, We'll follow the textbook. No problem. If you don't have the textbook, we'll have difficulty, right? If you have textbook, you can follow. Or you have mobiles, you can follow. Okay. We are in paragraph 9. Modern industry has established the world market for which the discovery of America paved the way. This market, you see, Karl Marx is pointing at America as the leader of capitalism. America is the leader of capitalism. The market has given an immense development to commerce, to navigation, to communication by land. Look here. Let's write. Okay. America. World market. So there is more commerce, there is more navigation by land and sea. Read ahead. Okay. This development has in its in turn reacted on the extension of industry. Okay. Look. Extension of industry, read ahead. And in proportion as industry, commerce and navigation, railways extended. Look here. Extension of railway. Railway extended in the same proportion. The bourgeoisie developed now. Do you see? Commerce, navigation, land and sea, industries, railway, All these are factors that have helped in the rise of the middle class. बाटो बनाए भने सामानलाई कसले बेच्छ? मिडिल क्लास. किसानले बेच्छ कि केले गर्छ? जति पनि मिन्स अफ कम्युनिकेसन छ नि, यो मिन्स अफ कम्युनिकेसनले कसलाई हेल्प गर्छ? मिडिल क्लास. जहाजमा किसान उठ्छ? मिडिल क्लास. रेलमा किसान हिँड्छ? मिडिल क्लास. राइट? किप इन माइन्ड, वाट आर दि फ्याक्टर्स द्याट कन्ट्रिब्युटेड टु द राइज अफ दि बुर्जुवा. राइट? अहिले पढौँ त. Increased its capital and pushed into the background every class handed down from the middle class. Now look, as bourgeois develops, there is more money. And when there is more money, there is more power. And when there is more power, now the bourgeois becomes the most powerful. तिमीले प्रचण्डले बोल्या सुन्छौ कहिले काहीँ फेसबुकमा? उहाँले के भन्नुहुन्छ? के गर्नु अब? एउटा सांसदको चुनाव लड्न 10 करोड चाहिन्छ. 10 करोड भएन भने चुनाव जित्दैन. लुक द ट्रुथ, बिटर ट्रुथ. अब त 10 करोड भएको मान्छे नि पोलिटिक्समा आउने भयो. तिमी आउन सक्छौ? म आउन सक्छु? 10 करोड कसो हुन्छ? बुर्जुवा छ नि. अब पोलिटिक्समा को आउने भयो? बुर्जुवा. So politics is controlled by the people who have money. Because you cannot do politics without money. Nidhaya cha bichara. Hamro Mona Lisa nidhaya ke nidhaya ki nidhaya copy sabai maanu. Politics is controlled by people who have money. Well, people who don't have money cannot be in politics. Okay, read next paragraph. Next, paragraph 10. We see therefore how the modern bourgeoisie, I told you two pronunciations, bourgeois and bourgeoisie, B-O-U-R-G-E-O-I-S, bourgeois, B-O-U-R-G-E-O-I-S-I-E, bourgeoisie. Say it, bourgeois. Say it, bourgeoisie. Divakar ji, just the bourgeoisie. Then say proletarian.
Proletariat.
We see therefore how the modern bourgeoisie is itself the product of a long course of development, of a series of revolutions in the modes of production and of exchange. Look. Look. See, Karl Marx said that. Karl Marx talked about two ideas. Base structure and superstructure. Base structure means economic realities or relations. Base structure means economic relations. And super structure means ideas, literature, beauty. And what Marx said that how you think depends on how you live. How you think depends on how you live. Jaisa khayega khana, वैसा ही गाएगा गाना. जैसा खाएगा खाना वैसा ही गाएगा गाना. योर थिंकिंग इज शेप्ड अकॉर्डिंग टू योर लाइफ स्टाइल. अकॉर्डिंग टू लाइफ स्टाइल. Tell me what you eat, I will tell you what you think. Meaning is, your economic class forms your thinking. Forms your thinking. Poor people have one kind of thinking, rich people have another kind of thinking. What you need to understand here, Bhulte Parikho Rakhe, as the economic relations change, class also changes. Gauma Basri Manchele, Rath Khan Chha. Tehi Gauli Manchele, Kahmandu Aara, Vyapar Gara, Paisa Kamaya Pachi, Bhuja Jivnaar Chha, Rath Khan Chha. Paisa Nakama Mandei, Gari Bhani Vala Vakki Khan Chha? Bhat. Dhani Vala Si Bhat Khan Chha? Khaadai Kutte Khan Chha Vuleva? Bhuja. Bhuja. Gari Bhuja Khan Chha. धनीवासी खाने नहीं क्या होता है जुनार होता है क्या होता है जुनार लुक योर लैंग्वेज चेंजेस विद द चेंज इन योर इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस डू यू थिंक वर पीपल रिच पीपल ऑफ सेम लैंग्वेज नो आई सी यू गेस यू काइस यू हु स्पीक्स दिस लैंग्वेज मिडिल एंड अपर क्लास राइट सो योर इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस is closely tied to your thinking. And here is the word base and superstructure. Base means economic reality. Base means economic reality. Superstructure means your lifestyle and thinking. Thinking. Right? Okay. Can I erase? Let's move ahead. So, here, we were here, right? This paragraph. We see, therefore, how the modern bourgeoisie is itself the product of a long course of development of a series of revolutions in the mode of production and action. You can have a question exam. Explain how the revolutions, write down, explain how the revolutions in the modes of production, explain how the revolutions in the modes of production and of exchange Explain how a series of revolutions in the modes of production and exchange developed the bourgeois class, 4 marks. अब घर घर लेखने को पेटिशन दे ले, लेखने घर घर, जांच पाऊं सही हो. Explain how a series of development in the modes of production exchange developed bourgeois class. कहाँ वाले हैं? Para 1 to para 9. Let's see para 11. Each step in the development of the bourgeoisie was accompanied by a corresponding political advance in that class. Now look here. Economic change brought rise of new class, right? This new class was the bourgeois class, right? And as the bourgeois class became more powerful, it began to control the political power. Look, economic power and political power go together. Economic power and political power go together. त्यही भएर हाम्रो नेताहरूले पैसा कमाउँछन् नि, उनीहरूलाई थाहा छ पैसा भए राजनीति छ, पैसा नभए राजनीति छैन। मैले फेरि प्रचण्डले भनेको सम्झेँ, एउटा वार्डको सदस्यको चुनाव लड्न 30 लाख चाहिन्छ भन्नुहुन्थ्यो उहाँले, सांसद लड्न 10 करोड चाहिन्छ भन्नुहुन्थ्यो उहाँले। अब 10 करोड भएको मान्छे नै चुनाव लड्ने भयो, नभए लड्ने भयो भएन नि। अहिले स्वर्णिम वार्डले जानुभएको छ चुनाव, तनुम चुनाव उहाँले ब्याङ्क खाता खोल्नुभएको छ हिजो, मलाई चन्दा चाहियो भनेर। अलिअघि रविन्द्र मिश्र पनि खोल्नुभएको थियो, अनि हिसाब पनि दिनुभयो। इफ यु हेभ मनी यु कन्ट्रोल पोलिटिक्स, इफ यु हेभ नो मनी यु कान्ट कन्ट्रोल पोलिटिक्स। सिधै रियाली Karl Marx is talking about today. Today's Nepal. How truly he says? With each economic change, there is rise of new class. For example, with the economic change of manufacturing system, we have bourgeois class. This bourgeois class has all the money. Right? So it has all the power. So it controls politics. Who controls politics today? The bourgeois class. Who?
Bourgeois class.
आज राजनीतिमा पैसा कसले हाल्छ? गिट्टी व्यापारीले, ढुङ्गा व्यापारीले, दलालले, जग्गा व्यापारीले, उद्योगीले, पोलिटिसियनले चन्दा दिन्छ नि, अनि बदलामा पोलिटिसियनले उनीहरूलाई करप्सन गरिदिन्छ। सिधो कनेक्सन बिट्विन बुर्जुवा एन्ड पोलिटिक्स, बुझ्नुहुन्छ? ओके, अगाडि पढाउँदा कस्तो कुरा छ। So each step in development of the bourgeoisie was accompanied by a corresponding political advance of that class. An oppressed class under the sway of feudal nobility, okay. Feudal nobility the middle class was exploited by the feudal lords, okay. An oppressed class under the sway of the feudal nobility, an armed and self-governing association in medieval commune. Look, Karl Marx is talking about, sunusta, Karl Marx is explaining the rise, development and role of middle class throughout history. So he says, in the past the middle class was exploited by feudal nobility. Nobility means noble people. Noble means higher class people. Feudal nobility means higher class people. They exploited nobility service. Middle class kahanbata suru bhayeko? Kahanbata suru bhayeko middle class? From the serfs. Middle class arose from the serfs. यो सर्फले कसँग विद्रोह गर्यो? सर्फले कसँग विद्रोह गर्यो? अनि त्यहाँ के डेभलप भयो? ओके, सो दे वर एक्सपर्ट देन इन द ओके एन आर्म्ड एन्ड सेल्फ गभर्निङ एसोसिएसन, दे क्रिएटेड एन आर्म्ड एसोसिएसन in the medieval commune, here independent urban republic as in Italy and Germany, their taxable third estate of the monarchy as in France. Afterwards, in the period of manufacturing proper, serving either the semi-feudal or the absolute monarchy, this middle class always supported either the feudal class or the king. That's why Karl Marx says middle class is a reactionary class, because the middle class does not support communism. Middle class supports monarchy. Middle class supports feudalism. Business class never supports communism. Business class never supports communism. They support the king. Middle class supports old system. Middle class is never ready for new revolution. That's why Karl Marx is criticizing middle class. Follow them? Okay. In the period of manufacturing proper, serving either a semi-feudal or absolute monarchy as a counterpoise against the nobility, and in fact, cornerstone of the great monarchies in general, the bourgeoisie has at last, since the establishment of the modern industry and of the world market, conquered for itself in the modern republican state exclusive political sway. Look, today, the bourgeoisie has full control of political power. Today, who controls political power? The middle class, the bourgeoisie. Today, even in Nepal, who controls political power? The bourgeoisie, middle class. See the last line. How bitter, what a bitter truth Karl Marx says. This is the last line of the paragraph, that's very important. Read here, the last line. The executive of the modern state means the council of ministers. The council of ministers or the cabinet. The executive of the modern state is but a committee for managing the common affairs of the whole bourgeois. Oh God. Look, state serves the bourgeois. You mother put it in the way. Meter bears the name. धनी ले मिलीमीटर ब्याज दिन दे बैंक ले धनी मान्छे लाई सस्तोमा ब्याज दिने दे बैंक ले गरीब मान्छे लाई महँगो ब्याज दिने के देखा बैंक त कमर्ट चल्छ नि यसले कसलाई हेल्प गर्यो धनीलाई के गरिरहेको द होल राज्य is serving the rich people. The line is the just found such a question. Explain how the executive of the modern state is but a committee for managing the common affairs of the whole bourgeois. What example did you? ल हेर्नुहोस् मलाई म कालीबाटी तरकारी किन्न जान्छु होलसेलमा अनि त्यहाँ उदाहरण फर इक्जाम्पल मैले बन्दकोपी सोधेँ अनि उसले चाहिँ किलोको 50 भन्यो एकछिनलाई कालीबाटीमा 50 रुपियाँमा बिक्ने बन्दकोपी त्यो व्यापारीले किसानसँग 5 रुपियाँमा किन्छ कतिमा किन्छ 5 किसानलाई त्यो बन्दकोपी फलाउँदा कस्ट नै 7 रुपियाँ पर्छ 2 रुपियाँ घाटा लाग्ला होइन अब व्यापारीले खेती गरे माटोमा हात हालेन पानीमा भिज्यो दुःख गरेन ऊ त कालबाटी बसेको छ फलाउँछ किसानले अनि त्यो 5 रुपियाँको बन्दकोपी 50 बेचेर 45 रुपिस कसले खान्छ व्यापारी भनेको बुर्जुवा क्लास सरकारले कुरा रोक्छ रोक्दैन त सरकार कसको पक्षमा रहेछ व्यापारी धान रोप्यो असारमा कि किसानलाई विकासी मल चाहियो होइन किसान चाहिँ मल चाहियो भन्छ सरकारले ल्याइदिँदैन तपाईँ न्युज हेर्नुहोस् लास्ट इयर पनि अघिल्लो वर्ष पनि हाम्रो कृषि मन्त्री इन्डिया जानुभयो किसान मल ल्याउनु नलिकन आउनुभयो सक्नुमा ल्याउनु अनि मल कहिले आउँछ धान पाकिसकेपछि मल आउँछ Our Sarkar Kisan of Paksama Reza Sarkar Kisan of Batamal Timele Dinta Sarkar Kisan of Baito Kisan of Tarkar Gadhar Vesu Porto Chitman Bachai Tarkari Father David Bada Dimitri Kino India Bada Bishadi Alego Tarkari Sostama Lady Nepal Tarkari Begin Nepal Cost Body Porenta Our Sarkarli to Rukin Portini Broken, broken. What is it? Sarkar, Nepali Kisanla Sarkar Risa? What is it? Nepal Sarkar, Nepal Jantako? I'm sorry on the camera, possibly video, everything, sorry, Bargagavala. But these are Karl Marx talks. The state mechanism is a committee to help and support the middle class. It has no concern with proletariat class. It never helps the farmers. Okay? Question I'm going to say, Mr. Agar, jaan question likha hai na? Ab yo question ko answer likhe ra, can scan gare ra, malai pathaun ho sa. Sir, malai likhe hai, so here no one is me, here din chanta. Okay. So from paragraph 1 to paragraph 12, Karl Marx discusses the development of the bourgeois class. From paragraph 2 on, 1 number 2. From paragraph 2, otherwise 6, whatever it is, 5, 6. Otherwise, up to paragraph 12, Marx discusses the development of what class? Bourgeois class. And he concludes that the bourgeois class has all political. The bourgeois class has all political. I have heard one thing. Example of politician, name I have camera. Ma, name is banned. But the media has come. Arup. President has Rolex. Gadi le banned. Arisa. And Rolex gadi ko minimum dam 60 lakh per se. 60 lakh. Ek pair wago jutta ko bhi dam aaya thi. Coat Armani ki coat dress arisa. Hey, 60,000 ko coat. वापस गए था सर्वारा को मतलब वहाँ पर नाम लिए कैमरा हाँ सॉरी ये सभी में थी लागू हो चाहे एवरी पॉलिटिशियन इज लाइक यू में डिसएग्री यू में अभी डोंट टेक अदरवाइज आई ब्रिंग दिस एग्जांपल्स टू हेल्प यू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ रिच क्लास इज कंट्रोलिंग पॉलिटिकल पावर बिकॉज दे हैव मनी इफ यू हैव मनी यू कैन डू पॉलिटिक्स राइट लेट्स मूव अहेड The bourgeoisie historically has played a most revolutionary society has changed a lot because the bourgeoisie, wherever it has got the upper hand, has put an end to feudal. Okay, let's write here. B-O-U-R-G-E-O-I-S-I-E. The bourgeoisie finished feudal, patriarchal, idyllic relations. Look, when there is money or when there is bourgeoisie, there is no human relation. There is no human relation. You go to the restaurant. The waitress smiles according to the amount of money you provide. हजार दिन हुन्छ एउटा स्माइल आउँछ सय दिन हुन्छ अर्को स्माइल आउँछ दिन हुन्न स्माइल आउने पनि एक्जाम पनि एक्जाम इफ युर ड्याडी गिभ्स यु लट अफ मनी हिज अ भेरी नाइस ड्याडी उहाँ राम्रो हुनुहुन्छ पैसा दिनुभयो इफ यु कान्ट गिभ यु मनी is not a nice guy. The point is, money has destroyed all human relations. Nobody does anything without money. Nobody does anything without money. Everyone is doing everything just for money. Money, money, money. मनी प्लांट रोपे मेरो मनी प्लांट में पैसा फल्ने कहिले हरिवंश सिंग्स दिस सॉन्ग इन द मूवी के घर के डेरा मनी मनी भनी मनी प्लांट रोपे मेरो मनी प्लांट में पैसा फल्ने सो वी ऑल आर रनिंग आफ्टर मनी एंड व्हाइल रनिंग आफ्टर मनी वी आर फॉरगेटिंग आवर पेरेंट्स वी आर फॉरगेटिंग आवर रिलेशनशिप्स ह्यूमैनिटी राइट humanity. So, right, Pandasar? It has pitilessly torn asunder the motley feudal ties. Look, all family relations are gone. All family relations are gone. They are bound man to his natural superiors and has left remaining no other nexus between man and man than naked self-interest, than callous caste. हिजो एउटा घर जाँदै थिएँ अगाडि गाडी घुमिरहेको थियो गाडी गइरहेको थियो कि जिप टाटा पहिले के लेखेको थियो थाहा छ क्यास हेयर क्यास एस नहेर लेखेको थियो पछाडि सरी अर्थ नमान्नु होला अर्थ नमान्नु होला के लेखेको थियो क्यास हेयर एस नहेर त्यो ड्राइभरले के चाहियो रहेछ Look, we realize everybody is dying for money. We are all dying for and when money becomes powerful, all humanity dies, all relations. Hijo padhe thiye Facebook ma arko kanda America ma basne kasaile Nepal ko amalai $400 pathaidiyecha. अनि लोग्नेले $400 आमालाई नेपालमा पठायो भनेर श्रीमतीले डिभोर्स फाइल गरिदिन्छ तसमा बस्दैन भने किन भन्दा त किन घर पैसा पठाउनु इफ यु वान्ट डिस्ट्रोय एनी रिलेसन ब्रिङ मनी इफ यु वान्ट टु डिस्ट्रोय एनी रिलेसन वाट सुड यु ब्रिङ मिल्ने साथी छ साथीलाई सिद्धाउनु पऱ्यो जस्ट पैसाको एक्सचेन्ज गर्नु भोलिबाट साथी तपाईँले हेर्दै छोड्छ पैसा पाउने बेलामा आहा गर्दै आउँछ पैसा पाएपछि भागिहाल्छ दिस इज व्हाट इज हाउ पिटर ट्रुथ हि रोट दिस डिकेड्स अगो इट इज सो ट्रु टुडे पढौँ त इट हेज ड्राउन्ड द मोस्ट ह्याप्पिली एक्सटेसिज अफ रिलिजियस फर्बर अफ सिमलस एन्थुजियाजम of Philistine sentimentalism in the icy water of egotistical calculation. Look. Calculation. मैले घरमा बुवालाई औषधि किनिदिए भने बुवालाई मलाई पाइदिनुहुन्छ कि के दिएको भन्दा होइन नराख्नु ₹10 तरकारी ल्याइदियो भने बुवाले क्यास मलाई दिनुहुन्छ हामी बुवा छोरामा के आयो पैसा आयो है म राखिहाल्छु पैसा अल्पल्छु इट हेज रिजल्ट पर्सनल वर्क इन टु एक्सचेन्ज वेल्थ ओके भ्यालु द कन्सेप्ट अफ भ्यालु पर्सनल वर्क exchange value अगाडि बढ्नु है एन्ड इन प्लेस अफ द नम्बरलेस इन्डिभिजिबल चार्टर्ड फ्रिडम हेज सेट अप द सिङ्गल अनकन्सिएबल अनकन्सिएबल फ्रिडम फ्री ट्रेड फ्री ट्रेड इन वन वर्ड फॉर एक्सप्लोइटेशन Held by religious and political illusion, it has substituted naked, shameless, direct, brutal exploitation. Naked, shameless, direct, brutal X plus B. What is exchange value? Look, the money that your college pays me for my service is exchange value. When I, okay, exchange, try, no, no, okay, Atithi. Atithi, no. This was Mundan. My neighbor is very little than this. My neighbor is very little than this. Look this in the house. Somewhere. Name is Somewhere. Yeah. You will be surprised, right? Okay, well, that's my name. And the reason I put to you are dementia is not so easy. You will be cheap is not so easy. Medal. Right there, right there. I want to sell this marker, right? Use marker, right? मैले 25 किनेको मैले 1 विक चलाइसकेँ कि इनिड मार्क लेट्स प्रिट हाउ मच विल पे फर दिस 25 दिस इज एक्सचेन्ज अब मैले उसलाई दिएँ उसले मलाई कति दिन्छ दिस एक्सचेन्ज अब अर्को हुन्छ अर्को भ्यालु पनि हुन्छ है त्यो मार्क मैले यहाँ बोकेर हेरेँ त्यसले मैले देख्यो वेज अफ प्रोफेसर भन्ने भ्यालु टिचर भयो नि त अर्को भ्यालु फेस भ्यालु एक्सचेन्ज भ्यालु साइन एक्सचेन्ज भ्यालु तिनवटा भ्यालु फेस भ्यालु